We've just shown how to position and orient a camera in world space. If we apply this matrix C to some camera object, the camera then gets placed in the world. However, we want exactly the opposite of this. We don't want to position the camera with respect to the world. We want to position the world with respect to the camera. Think about what's happening. We have some objects in a scene. They perhaps had a number of modeling transforms applied to them. The objects are now all positioned in world space. What we want to do now is transform the world to the camera's frame of reference. Here's a camera and a model. Say we slide the camera 5 units along the world's x-axis. From the camera's point of view, if we subtracted 5 from all the world coordinates, everything would be nicely oriented for the camera. The long and short here is that we use the inverse of the matrix that would position the camera in the world. Inverting basically says, no, it's all about me, the camera. Reorient everything with respect to me, me, me. This inverse matrix is called the view matrix. For this reason, this view matrix is sometimes written as the inverse of the camera matrix, the matrix that would move the camera to its place in world space. Another way to think of this view transform is simply as the very last modeling matrix in the chain. The M matrix here represents all the transforms needed to get the object into world space. Modeling transforms. Now one last transform, the view matrix V, takes the objects in world space and moves them into the camera's frame of reference. If you deal with WebGL or OpenGL directly, you'll see these two matrices put together as a single matrix called the model view matrix. This matrix is applied to an object, immediately taking it from its own model space to view space.